Democrats in the House of Representatives, for some reason, announced this week that they have ramped up their investigation into Jared Kushner and the business deals that he secured for his family's businesses while also serving in the Trump White House. Now, as we all know, come January 3rd, a brand new Congress gets sworn in. And it's going to be a Congress that is run by Republicans, which literally means the Democrats have days left to investigate Jared Kushner's possible influence peddling from his time in the Trump administration. Days. And with days remaining, they're like, oh, we've ramped it up. We're really going to take a good hard look. You don't have time. Like, time is up. Why are you even still working on it at this point? Because there's no way in hell, because you just sent out letters this week requesting info, you can't do anything with it. Here's the thing. Jared Kushner, while he was working with the Trump administration, completely divested, allegedly, from the Kushner Company. He had nothing to do with it. He got rid of all of his holdings. But his company also took out a massive loan to pay for the property 666 Fifth Avenue. Then, when they were on the verge of defaulting because they couldn't pay that, they got in a ton of money from, allegedly, a Canadian bank. What this House panel of Democrats is trying to find out was there actual Middle Eastern money that came in that you're trying to hide, and did the money come in due to Kushner's influence, where Kushner successfully got a blockade of Qatar removed? Like, he spent a lot of time in Qatar. There was a blockade with several other Middle Eastern countries refusing to do business with them. They said Qatar is a state sponsor of terrorism. The United States said as much. Kushner comes back from Qatar, tells Donald Trump, hey, we gotta end this blockade. We gotta help Qatar with their economy. Trump goes to the other countries. Eventually, the blockade gets lifted. So, was there Qatari money that helped bail out this building that they purchased? That's what they want to find out. And kind of seems like you should have been asking these questions in January of 2021 when you took power, not December of 2022 when there's literally just days left in your current session before the Republicans take over and kill this investigation. We're not going to get these answers. Like, this is the real presidential family, you know, nepotism, influence peddling scheme that we should be focused on, not Hunter Biden and his stupid laptop. This kind of seems like a big deal. And like I said, we will never get the answers to this because the Democrats waited and only decided to ramp up the investigation when they're looking at the calendar and realizing, holy crap, we got like a week and a half till Christmas. Maybe we ought to do something about this. Too little, too late, right? And that is infuriating because this thing stinks from the top to the bottom. But we'll never know if corruption did take place because the Democrats sat too damn long.
This is Hattie. Hattie wants to know why you have not subscribed to our channel. You obviously like our videos, so do us a favor and subscribe.